just to hear your still small voice again. Holy, righteous, faithful till the end. Savior, healer, redeemer, and friend. I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are, Jesus. In your presence, thinking of the good things you have done, waiting here patiently, just to hear your still small voice again. You're holy, you're righteous, faithful till the end. Savior, healer, redeemer, and friend. Worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are, Jesus.
I will worship.
I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are, Jesus. My soul secure,
yes, Lord.
Your promise sure, your love endures always. My soul secure,
yes, Lord. Your promises are
your
sure.
I lift my praise to
Shadow in your presence.
before the Holy One of Heaven. It's only by your blood, and it's only through your mercy, Lord, I come. I bring an offering of worship to my King.
We worship you, Lord.
May you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. I bring an offering of worship to
Basta din natin kamay sa Panginoon.
No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. I bring an offering of worship to my King. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. I bring an offering.
Worship to Him. I bring an offering of worship, of thanksgiving and prayer. I bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring.
Ano, minsan paawitin natin na.
I bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering. Oh Lord, I bring an offering.
So God, we worship you. Let us enjoy the presence of the Holy Spirit in this place.
Center of it all.
at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, nothing. Center of my life, Jesus, be the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, nothing else.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, you are the master of it all.
Come on, church.
Hallelujah.
We can call on the name of Jesus today.
Hallelujah. Center of it all, God. Hallelujah. You are the center of it all. Oh, hallelujah. It's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you. It's all about you, God. Hallelujah. Be the center of all the things that we are doing this morning. Be the center of it all, God. Touch each and every one of us this morning, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want for all of us to just lift up our hands. Just reach out to the Lord this morning. Reach out to Him right now. Reach out to Him. It's all about Jesus. It's all about God. Hallelujah. Just reach out to Him this morning. Hallelujah. Be the center. Be the center of my life, God. Be the center. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Let's sing it softly. Sing it softly. I want for all of us to sing. It's all about us. Softly now.
Jesus, be the center of
all. It's all about you.
It's all about you. From my heart to the heavens. Jesus, be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you.
Don't stop. Don't stop. Rightful place in our hearts. Be the center of my heart, God. Be the center of my heart. Yes. Hallelujah. Just touch us this morning, God, with your presence. It's all about Jesus. Oh, it's all about you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Just let the presence of God just permeate in our hearts this morning. Let it go. Let it go deeper into our spirits. Hallelujah. It's all about you. Just set aside every fear, every worry, every anxiety. Just come before Him in worship, in an adoration for who He is, what He means to you. Lord, I hunger and thirst for more of you, Jesus. Lord, fill us with your presence this morning. This is all about you. We are calling on you, Jesus. We are calling on you, Jesus, this morning. Breathe us in us. Breathe in us, God. Sharadayara. Hallelujah. I just sense the anointing of the Lord is so heavy this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want for us to hold hands together. Hold hands together. All over this room. Hallelujah. Hold hands. Let it flow. Let it flow to each and every one of you. The anointing that is coming from the throne room of God is being passed on to each and every one of us. And every sickness has to low in Jesus' name. Every fear has to go in Jesus' name. Relationships be restored in Jesus' name. Every fear and every worry be dispelled in Jesus' name. Let the love of God just flow to each and every one of us this morning. Hallelujah. It's all about Jesus. It's all about Jesus and what He is doing to each and every one of us. Let His presence fill this room. Let His anointing fill this room right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, brosote ya. Hallelujah. Shikti ya ratosu. Can we sing that chorus once again? Just the vocals. It's okay, no instruments, just vocals. Sharabasote Rebellion.
Jesus be the center, it's all about you. Yes, it's
Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you.
Jesus, Jesus, oh Lord God, be glorified, be glorified. Take your rightful place in our hearts this morning, God. Have your way. Let your Holy Spirit orchestrate everything, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just don't know how you could stand this anointing. Woo! Oh, God! Hallelujah. 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 No. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus be the center of it all. You know, sometimes when we're in standing in the anointing of the Lord, you just don't know how He will move. Remember last Sunday? How many of you here were here last Sunday? It was not planned. We had nothing to do with it. It was the plan of the Holy Spirit. See, this is what it's all about, what Jesus is doing in our midst. Yes, we prepare. We do all the things that we need to do. But at the end, it is what God wants to do. It is what the Holy Spirit would lead us in what He wants to do. Hallelujah. Sometimes, I'll be honest with you. Sometimes I hesitate singing this kind of songs. You know why? Because it goes deep into my heart and I look inward and ask myself, Jesus, are you really the center of it all? Sometimes it's not really about singing and singing and singing. But what is it doing in your heart? I will be ministering to you this morning outside of, probably I would touch on some of the things, but I would like to go directly to your heart. What He means to you. Remember Matthew chapter 16, what I shared a few weeks back, probably the most important question that has been asked you, who do you say the Son of Man am? Remember that?
Yes.
Now, you ask yourself, who do you say? Kayo po, not anybody else. Kayo. Who do you say? Who do I say? Who do I say the Son of Man am? Are you getting it? It's going down to reality where the rubber meets the... You may sit down. It's going to reality where the rubber meets the road. Where you are right now. We were singing a while ago, be the center of this church. I may add on, be the center, because we said, be the center of it all. All refers to everything. Is Jesus the center of your family? Okay. Is Jesus the center of your business? Is Jesus in the center of your work, of your job? Is Jesus in the center of all the things? Be the center of it all. Is Jesus the center of it all? You see, we have been discussing along the lines of kingdom living, kingdom principles, kingdom consciousness, divine acceleration, supernatural acceleration, right? Cutting a new path. Now, all of this, listen to me closely, all of this hinges on your relationship with God. If Jesus is really the center of it all, nothing else matters. Everything is just put on the side because He will be the one to orchestrate everything in our lives. Amen. Now, thank you, worship team. That was wonderful. Amen. Let's give a hand to them. Thank you. Kaya nga ako minsan, sometimes in oh Lord, help me God, help me Jesus. But sometimes it really ministers to me. That's why I'm feeling this way. Even in the songs, every time I would sing songs, it really ministers to me. That's why I can't understand myself. Because talagang umaano eh. Yun ang nararamdaman ko eh. It really ministers to me first. Kaya when we were singing, Jesus be the center, I was pondering in my mind, are you really the center of it all? In all the things that we are doing in our lives, is Jesus really the center? Hallelujah. But anyway, last week, probably some of you were wondering, it was not the usual way of doing the service. Diba, kumisa na sanay na tayo. Meron tayong opening song, and then what comes after the opening song? Testimony, meron tatayo sa ating encore, and then testimony, and then we go to praise and worship. And then after that comes the word, and then ministry time. So it's been like that. But Sunday was kind of different. There was a different moving of the Holy Spirit. Now, that's why, if we are sensitive to the moving of the Holy Spirit, sometimes the direction that we are going it will be different. But what I've noticed, even wala po sa programa, wala sa usual na ginagawa natin last Sunday, but everything was in order. Diba? Everything would just flow naturally. Wala pong confusion, walang chaos. And on top of that, there was a confirmation. There was a witness in the spirit of our pastor. Amen? And she was even the one that confirmed, because it was her dream before of what the Holy Spirit had spoken to Pastor Ton. Let me tell you, and this goes for every one of us, a dream delayed is not a dream denied. Amen? Philippians chapter 1 and verse 6, it says, being confident of this. You're all familiar with the scriptures. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will be faithful to fulfill it or to accomplish it. Pwede ba natin i-flash so that the people can see? Philippians chapter 1 and verse 6. Being confident of this until, sabi ganun, being confident of this very thing. What is he talking about? The very thing, the very purpose that he called you. See, in the life of Pastor Ton, this is the very call that as God has intended or purposed for him. This is the very thing. Right? Even kay Pastora says eh. That's why it was confirmed to her that, you see, anyway, that he who began a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. There is always a day of completion. Amen? There is always, whatever God had started, He for sure He will finish it. Kung minsan tayo po ang naghihinawa, tayo ang nag-give up. No matter how impossible it may be, no matter how long it has taken, still it will come to pass because it has a date of completion. Amen? The moment, God placed a dream in your heart that starts it all. God starts it and He will be the one to finish it. Sabi nga, be in confidence of this very thing that He who began a good work, God was the one who, sabi nga nun, who started a good work in you. And He will be the one to fulfill it, to complete it, until, ano po sabi? Until the day of Jesus Christ. Dumating na ba ang Panginoon? Ba't meron sabing amen? sige, ginulo ko kayo. Dumating na ba sa pangalawang beses ang Panginoon? Hindi pa. Mas nagkaintindihan tayo. Okay? So, sa pangalawang beses, hindi pa siya dumadating until the day of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hindi pa nagkakaroon ng katuparan yun. Amen? So, yung inyo pong mga panaginip at ipinangako ng Panginoon sa inyo ay magkakaroon pa rin ng fulfillment, ng completion. Amen? Now, huwag niyo pong kalimutan or give up on the dreams that God has given you. It was for a purpose last Sunday that was the completion of Pastora Cesar's dream. Amen? Right? Are you getting this? It was the date of completion para sa kanya. Da kasi si Pastor Ton, kita niyo naman yung kanilang ano, mga dinaanan. Kayo ba naman eh, naranasan niyo na ba kung saan kayo nagplansya, doon na rin kayo kakain? Hello? Now, what is your ultimate desire? Think about it. What is your ultimate desire? Yumaman? Come on. What is your ultimate desire? Huwag niyo pong ialis sa isipan ninyo, I'll be driving home in regards to your relationship with Jesus. Because it's all about Him. Sabi nga ganun ni A.A. Tozer, sabi niya ganun, the most neglected subject that is being taught in churches is about God Himself. Tinuruan na po tayo ng katakot-takot na kaalaman, pero wala po ang patungkol sa Panginoon. Tinuruan po tayo ng tungkol sa ministry skills, leadership qualities, no? Economics, and everything. Pero ang patungkol po sa ating Panginoon, hindi masyadong natatouch. Kaya nga, what is your ultimate desire? You see, there is a powerful desire that will liberate your heart. Pagod na po kayo ba? I remember my oldest grandson, sabi niya ganun para sa kanya, sabi ganun niya sa papa niya, Papa, hindi pa tayo nag-ultimate vacation. Para sa kanya kasi, yung mga ordinaryong punta kasi tiga Pampanga sila, yung pupunta lang dito sa Manila or magpupunta ng Baguio, hindi para sa kanya, hindi yung ultimate vacation, hindi yon. Probably what I would term as an ultimate vacation is probably you went abroad, di ba? Tapos nag-shopping kayo ng katakot-takot, mga ganon. Parang yun ang ultimate vacation para sa kanya. Now, sa atin, lahat tayo, meron tayong desire. Right? Every human being has a desire. Now, what is your ultimate desire? See, an ultimate desire is so powerful, it will liberate your heart. It will unveil your destiny. Right? It will fill you with spiritual satisfaction. It will give you a powerful longing. A holy obsession. Yan po ang ginagawa ng isang ultimate desire. A holy obsession, an ultimate desire. Kasi many of us think that the Jesus that we receive is somebody who will just save us and stamp our passport so that we can enter heaven. We have experienced Jesus as the one who guides, who heals, who provides. Diba lahat yan? Pero up to ganun lang. And some of us, nakakalungkot po, the Jesus that we know was the one who taught us, who was the one we learned in Sunday school. At hanggang ngayon, nandun pa rin tayo sa ganung konsepto about Sunday school. But you know what? We have to have an ultimate desire in knowing Him more. Right? Alam niyo po, sabi pong ganun dito, there is no aspect of God's grace that can be more powerful in transforming our emotions and satisfying our soul
than when the Holy Spirit reveals to us Jesus. We need the Holy Spirit to reveal to us things about God. I believe the most transforming and exciting reality in the kingdom of God is the person of Jesus Himself. Amen? We can talk all day about the things in this life, but at the end of it all, it will only be Jesus that can satisfy us. It will only be Jesus that can transform us. Marami po sa atin nakakarinig na ng word and so on and so forth, but the question is, are we being transformed? Now, dito po makikita po natin, when I was going through this study, nadala po ako kay Apostle Paul. There was something in the conversion of Apostle Paul that really made a big difference in his life. Kasi si Apostle Paul, nung nakakilala siya sa Panginoon, he was a changed man. It was only an encounter, sabi pong ganun, Acts chapter 9. Tingnan po natin, Acts chapter 9. Acts chapter 9. Starting from verse 1. I pray to the Lord that all of us will have some kind of an encounter or an experience like that of Paul. Kasi kay Paul pa lang, isa pa lang yung encounter niyang nadaanan, nagbago na ang buong buhay niya. Eh sa atin po, nakailang beses na tayong encounter eh. Naka-encounter na tayo sa Piniel, naka-encounter na tayo sa Real. Nabago ba talaga ang buhay natin? Nagkaroon ba ng turnaround in such a way na masasabi natin, I was that like of Paul, the experience of Paul, na ganun ang na-experience ko, talagang complete around. Titingnan po natin mamaya kung sino si Paul talaga. And what he gave up. Para masabi niya po yun sa Philippians chapter 3 verse 8. I count all things lost for the excellence of the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Acts chapter 9. Sabi pong ganun dito. Then Saul, are you with me? Then Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked letters from him to the synagogues of Damascus, so that if he found any who were of the way, yun po yung kanilang ano nun, fellowship nila nun, whether men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. Verse 3. As he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven. Then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Continue. And he said, who are you, Lord? See, this is something about Paul. He recognized somebody that is in authority. Kaya sinabi po niyo rito, who are you, Lord? Then the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. It is hard for you to kick against the goats. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng goats? You can apply this in two ways. Goats meaning to say, yung pong you cannot go against the law. The law is the law. Whether you like it or not, the law at that time will take place, right? And the other one, if you have a call, the very purpose of God in your life, you cannot go against it. Amen? Marami po sa atin, we are going against our purpose. We are going against our call. Right? It is impossible. Sabi pong ganun dito, it will be impossible. It's hard for you to kick against the goat. You cannot go against it.
kung yan po ang panawagan sa inyo ng Panginoon, then yan po ang magkakaroon ng katuparan. Kaya po humahaba ang ating lakbay. Hindi tayo nagkakaroon ng sinasabi natin na I have received what God is asking me to do. It's because sinusubukan po natin gawin ang iba-ibang bagay pero hindi po tayo talaga nagko-concentrate or nagpupunta doon sa ating panawagan talaga. Yung very purpose. That's why it's very important for us. As we are taught by the Word, kung ano po ang ating purpose. It's very important for us to know about it. Verse 6, so he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what do you want me to do? Then the Lord said to him, arise and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do. And the man who journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice but seeing no one. Then Saul arose from the ground, and when his eyes were open, he saw no one. But they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And he was 3 days without sight, and neither ate nor drink. Ano po ang nangyari kay Apostle Paul? Alam niyo po, si Apostle Paul, in studying about his life, unang-una po, he was a Hebrew and a Pharisee. Ibig po sabihin nun, no one could accuse him of indifference or setting a low standard. Secondly, he studied under Gamaliel. Ibig sabihin po nito, no Jew could say that he doesn't know scriptures. Thirdly, nakatira po siya sa Tarsus. This made him a Roman citizen. He was acquainted with the worldly system. Okay? And pang-apat, he was an excellent communicator, an articulate communicator. Ang galing po ni Paul. Kaya, sabi pong ganun, he wrote 2/3 of the New Testament. Now, ang isa pa po ay he hotly pursued righteousness. This is one thing about Paul. Kasi yung obsession niya at that time, pumulot po tayo ng experience ni Paul. He was so obsessed with the things that he was doing, kaya kahit anong sagabal ang umabot po sa kanya, hindi niya iniintindi. He will just do what was in his heart. Now, what is your ultimate desire? Because your ultimate desire will propel you in doing or achieving that very thing. Are you getting this? Nasusundan niyo po ako? Kaya si Apostle Paul, when he had that conversion, when he had that encounter, he was a totally changed man. Now, ang obsession niya is to know him more. Kaya nga sabing ganun eh, I count all things lost for the excellence of the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Philippians chapter 3 and verse 8. For us, dito nga sa church, tayo po ay pinagpala. Lahat po ng katuraan, lahat po ng mga ways ay ginagawa natin. Meron po tayong cell group, meron po tayong Bible school. We go out, this church goes out of its way para ma-plant po sa inyo ang word, ma-plant sa atin ang word. Hello? And yet, medyo hindi natin po binibigyan ng value. Kasi, meron po tayong ibang obsession. Right? Meron po tayong ibang obsession. Nakikita po natin sa ating kapaligiran, mga tao pong obsessed in probably sabihin na natin, ano ba may example natin kung saan sila na-obsess? Gadget, Facebook. Sabihin na natin, eto na lang, you could identify with this because it's all in the news. Diba? Kung ano bang mga ang talagang nag-ano ngayon, pinaka-hot na issue. Ano? Pork barrel. PD, ano yan, Pastor? PDAF. Hot na hot po yan. Pero tingnan nyo po, yung mga taong involved doon, yun ang kanilang obsession. They are obsessed with that. Amen? Nakikita nyo po ba to? Iba-iba pong klaseng obsession meron po ang tao. Pero bottom line, pera ang ano? Pera ang pinaka matindi. Doon sila talaga obsessed. They will go out of their way para makakuha po ng bagay na yon. Now, balik po tayo kay Paul. Ang sabi po ng binasa po natin, in his conversion, in his encounter, one-time encounter, he was a completely changed man. Now, I believe in my heart that hindi lang po siya yun eh. I believe that the Holy Spirit was there all the time in Paul's life, guiding him. Because it is only the Holy Spirit, through the Holy Spirit, that can reveal Jesus to us. Now, alam po natin that the Holy Spirit will not force in us yung mga bagay po tungkol sa Panginoon. If you, how much are you hungry for the Lord? If you are hungry for the Lord, nakagaya ng kay Paul, then He will fill you. Depende po yan eh. Para sabihin po natin, meron po tayong container. Meron po tayong container. Gano'n nyo gusto karami ang ilagay sa inyong container? Depende po yan sa inyo. Amen? Dito rin po, the Holy Spirit will reveal to you about Jesus as you are hungry for Him. Are you getting this? Ngayon, kung ang hunger nyo po para sa ating Panginoon ay tuwing linggo lamang, de, panglinggo lang po kayo. Ganun lang po kasi ang hunger natin eh. Amen? Wag po tayong mawala, ano? What I'm driving at is your relationship with Jesus. Kung gaano po kayo kahungry sa ating Panginoon, ganun din po ang ibubuhos ng banal na Espiritu sa inyo. It is only the Holy Spirit who can reveal to you. Now, as I have said, kung hindi po talaga natin lalakihan ang ating container para maka-receive tayo ng mas marami patungkol sa Panginoon, wala pong mangyayari. Remember, yung sinabi ko one time, yung aking testimony. Pray ako ng pray, Lord, I want more of you, I want more of you, I want more of you. Pero I don't spend time with Him. So kung ano lang yung time na ibinibigay ko sa Panginoon, yun lang ang nare-receive ko. So if you put this much amount of time in knowing the Lord, yun din ang ibibigay. I'm sure you're all familiar with what I'm saying. Amen? The more you get to know Him, the more makikita po natin kung sino talaga tayo. Dito po, nakita po natin. Tingnan po natin sa 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Tingnan po natin sa 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 10 to 12. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 10 to 12. Now read with me. But God has revealed them to us through His Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. For what man knows the things of man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. Verse 12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God. Nakita po natin to. Freely given to us by God. Tingnan natin uli yung verse 11. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. So it is the Holy Spirit that really reveals to us about Jesus. Amen? Now, I will not go on and touch about the Holy Spirit because it's totally a different subject. Mahaba po yun. Let's go to John chapter 16. John chapter 16, verses 13 and 14. John 16, 13 and 14. However, when He, the Spirit of truth, has come, He will guide you into all truth, for He will not speak of His own authority, but whatever He hears, He will speak, and He will not tell you things to come. He will glorify me, for He will take of what is mine and declare it to you. So marami na pong mga bagay na ni-reveal sa atin ang ating Holy Spirit. Amen po ba? Now here, Paul found a treasure in Jesus. That's why, nung nakakilala po siya sa Panginoon, kakaiba na po eh. Nag-iba ang kanyang buhay because of the revelation of the Holy Spirit to Paul. Now, tingnan po natin the truth about Jesus. The primary battlefront in the kingdom of God is the truth about Jesus. Ano po ba talaga ang naririnig natin sa ating kapaligiran patungkol sa ating Panginoon? Because, sad to say, nagkaroon na po ng mga katuruan at mga preachings about Jesus of this age. It's not about Jesus of the Bible. Eh. It's not about Jesus of Scriptures. It's about Jesus of this age. It's about a Jesus that has conformed to our image and likeness. Ang ginawa po ng mundo ay ginawa po nilang domesticated God. A God that has adapted to our ways. Ganun po ang ginagawa. Pinervert po ng kaaway. Because ang ating po, ang kaaway po natin, He will do all He can para malinlang po tayo, ma-deceive tayo. Sabi pong ganun ng Bible, He is just a roaring lion seeking whom He may devour. But He is already a defeated foe. Amen? Ang primary weapon na ginagawa niya ay deception. Dinideceive niya. Kaya pumasok na rin po sa church, sa iglesia, ang mga iba-ibang katuruan patungkol po sa ating Panginoon. Kumisan po, itinuturo nila that Jesus does not demand anymore of our time, our money, our words, our social life, our sexuality, and so on and so forth. Kaya po marami tayong nakikita in our society, even in mga celebrities po na nakikita natin, pinepervert po nila. They say they are Christians, pero hindi mo po makikita sa buhay nila. Right? Amen po ba? Nakikita po natin yan. Kagaya, I'm sure pagka sinabi ko si Oprah Winfrey, she openly announced sa international TV that hindi lang po ang iisa na papasok po sa langit. Pinervert po. Amen? Kasi ang ginagawa po ng sanlibutan ngayon, dinadivert nila ang attention dun sa Jesus na sinasabi sa Bible at ang ginagawa nila, Jesus of this age. A domesticated God. Kaya kuminsan po, makikita natin sa mga ibang tao, pagdating sa pera nila, pagdating sa time nila, pagdating sa social life nila, pagdating po sa kanilang sexuality, wala pong pakialam ang ating Panginoon. Ganun po ang ginawa nila. Jesus now, or God now, is a domesticated God, a Jesus after our image. Pero ano pong sabi ng Bible kasi? We were created in the image and likeness of God. Binaligtad nila. Ang ginawa nila, now we have a God, we have a Jesus that is after our own image, that is conformed to this age and time. Are you getting this? Kaya marami pong mga tao sa sanlibutan, they are confused. They don't know the real Jesus that the Bible is talking about. And we need the Holy Spirit. Now, ito po yung talagang primary battle. Marami pong mga iglesia, I'm sorry to say that religion will not take you to Jesus or will not reveal you to Jesus. Religion will not get you to heaven. Religion will not take you to God. Sabi pong ganoon sa John chapter 14 verse, chapter 14 verse 6, I am, sabi ganoon na Jesus, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Diba? Now, for us to know about Jesus, kailangan natin, number one, we need the Holy Spirit to reveal to us because it is the Holy Spirit. And secondly, kung ano po ang hunger natin sa Panginoon, yun din ang mabibigay sa atin. Amen? Alam niyo po, tayo, we have things in our life. We have, sabihin natin, secret things, sabihin na natin, in our life. Na sinasabi natin na, Lord, pagdating dito, huwag mo na itong papakilaman. Dito sa ibang bagay, okay ka dyan. Di ba? Pero dito, huwag mo na pakilaman to. Sa akin na lang to. Hindi po pwede yung ganun eh. What we are doing, we are trying, kagaya po ng nabanggit ko, we are trying to conform Jesus to our standards. We cannot do that. We have to conform ourselves, line up ourselves with what the Word is saying. Amen? Kaya, kung ang pagkakaunawa lang po natin sa Panginoon about Jesus, save me, and He will stamp my passport and I can now enter heaven, kung yun lang po ang pagkakaalam natin, then you are missing a lot. Kaya nga po, ang ating pag-church ay hindi po talagang ganun tayo ka-excited. Pwedeng nag-church tayo, pwedeng hindi tayo nag-church, we can just live without going to church. Hello? Nakakalungkot po. Ang mga iba pong Kristiyano, they can live without going to church. Kaya pag dumating po ang persecution, trials, testings, ay ano po nangyayari sa kanila? madali po silang bumibigay. Because ang pagkakaalam lang po nila sa kanilang Panginoon is somebody that saved us from going to hell. That's all. Now, ang isa pa pong kumakalat sa ating sanlibutan ay yung sinasabi lang, dinidiscredit nila, mga heresies po ito, dinidiscredit nila about the Godhead of Jesus. Hindi raw siya Diyos. Amen? Makikita po natin, one of the greatest passages in scriptures is Hebrews chapter 1. I encourage you to be familiar with Hebrews chapter 1. Tingnan po natin ang Hebrews chapter 1. Alam niyo po, this will equip the saints. It will equip the saints, tayo po yon, para ma-distinguish natin, ma-identify natin kung ano ang heresy at kung ano ang katotohanan. Kailangan po natin yan para hindi po tayo na-deceive. Kaya kung minsan po, di ba, babalitaan natin, meron tayong kaibigan, nag-a-attend na dito sa church natin sa Rhema, tapos biglang, whoop, nawala. Napunta doon sa kabila ron. Bakit? Why? Hindi sila established doon sa kanilang identity with Christ. Kaya magsabing gano'n ng Bible, they are easily swayed to and fro with every kind of doctrine. Tama ba sabing gano'n? In the last days, di ba sabing gano'n? In the last days, even seducing spirits, deceiving spirits would come in and deceive the saints. Right? Kaya para tayo po ma-establish sa ating pinaninindigan, kailangan natin malaman kung ano ang sinasabi ng scriptures patungkol po sa ating Panginoon. Meron po ako isang kaibigan. Noong una, Iglesia siya. Tapos after a while, meron siyang nakausap na tiga dating daan, napunta na doon sa dating daan. Pag ganun-ganun. Tapos meron naman one time, meron akong kaibigan pastor sa Bacolod. Nung narinig po niya yung katuruan ng isang ministro, dati ano siya, pre-trib. Ngayon, nakarinig siya ng bagong tuwan na mid-trib. So, nag-mid-trib ngayon siya. Para po tayo ma-establish sa ating pananampalataya, para tayo ma-establish sa ating beliefs, doctrines, kaya po sinulat ang Hebrews chapter 1. Lalo-lalo na po sa deity ng ating Panginoong Jesus. Para hindi po tayo malinlang, kasi maraming heretic na lumalabas. Tingnan po natin ang Hebrews chapter 1. So dito, makikita rin po natin, lalong-lalo na rin po, pagka we are faced with persecution. Verse 1, Hebrews 1, chapter 1, verse 1. Tingnan po natin to. Ano po sabi? God who at various times and in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets. Verse 2. Has in these last days spoken to us by His Son, whom He has appointed heir of all things, through whom also He made the worlds. Next. Who being the brightness of His glory and the express image of His person, and upholding all things by the word of His power, when He had by Himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of Majesty on high. So makikita po natin dito, very clearly dinidiscuss po kung ano po ang deity ng ating Panginoon. Hebrews chapter 1. Para makita po, ma-establish tayo. I will just enumerate all of this and I will end with this. Okay? Sabi pong ganun dito, dito sa Hebrews chapter 1 pa lang, para ma-establish ninyo ang inyong relationship sa ating Panginoon. Here in Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 to 3, you will see 7 excellencies. 7 excellencies of Jesus. Dito po sa mga talatang ito, makikita po natin, number 1, heir of all. I will not have time anymore to explain. But sabi pong ganun dito, in Hebrews chapter 1, it mentions of 7 excellencies. Ine-encourage ko na lang kayo na you read Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. Para ma-establish muna kayo in going back to your relationship para po mas mapatatag ang ating relationship sa Panginoon natin. Let us meditate on Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. Kasi dito makikita natin 7 excellencies. Alright? Nakita nyo? Unang-una, heir of all. Second is the creator of the worlds. Makikita po niyo lahat yan as you go through it again. Number 3 is the radiance of God. Number 4 is the exact representation of the Father. Makikita niyo po yan dyan. Number 5, the sustainer. Number 6, redeemer. And number 7, ruler of the universe. Okay? Don't worry. Next time, I will share all of this to you. All 7. Iisa-isahin po natin. Pero gusto ko lang muna at this present time, you meditate on Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 to 3 para makita po natin about the excellencies of God. Alam niyo po, Jesus is the full and final message to humanity about God. Amen? Kaya, idinidiin po natin about having a personal, a deeper relationship with Jesus. Kasi at these last days, the full and final message is about Jesus. Wala na pong yung iba. You will always go back to Jesus. Kaya nung kinanta po natin kanina, Jesus is the center of it all. When everything has been said and done, at the bottom line of it all, at the end of the road, it will only be about Jesus. Now, kagaya po ng nabanggit ko kanina, the Holy Spirit will reveal more of Jesus to you. How much hungry are you for Jesus? Kung gaano po kayo kagutom, kagaya ngayon, gutom na siguro kayo. Right? Kaya mamaya, kung gaano kayo kagutom, ganun din ang kain nyo. Tama? Kung hindi kayo masyadong gutom, de, konti lang. Same thing. Kung gaano kayo kagutom sa Panginoon, ganun din ang kakainin ninyo. Take the experience of Paul. Right? He was obsessed with the knowledge of knowing God. The Father, through the Holy Spirit, also revealed to us about God. About Jesus, rather. So, to reject Jesus, ito pong nakakalungkot doon sa mga ibang cults na lumabas. They rejected Jesus. In rejecting Jesus, you also rejected God. That's the truth about it. Right? Now, sabi ganon, after you have done all this, you stand knowing the Lord. Amen? Pagbulay-bulay niya, I want the worship team now. pagbulay-bulayan po natin. It is always good to not every now and then, but a lot of times, we evaluate ourselves. Whatever it is that you're doing, whether you are also in ministry, you are in business, you have a job, you are a student, evaluate po natin. Do not allow the things of this world to take us away and divert us into having a personal and a deeper relationship with God. Remember this, you always balance. Amen? Balance, always balance it out. Nakakalungkot po kasi kung minsan, there will be, I know of a lot of Christians and even those that we have mentored and discipled in Bible school. Nakakalungkot po. After all the training that they have gone through, you will sometimes hear na wala na sila sa Panginoon. Saan napunta yung naitanim sa kanila? Kaya nga, what we are trying to do is to give you the word, to preach to you the word. Next time I will share with you about what grace and what grace is not. Sometimes kasi dahil sa grace, napabayaan na natin eh. Amen? Hindi natin na talaga yung tunay na biyaya ng Panginoon. Kasi pagka nakita natin yung tunay na biyaya, yung tunay na grace ng Panginoon na sinasabi sa scriptures, hindi po tayo maliligaw sa ating mga ginagawa. Amen po ba? So let's all rise. Thank you, Jesus. Can we sing that song one more time? Jesus, you're the center. As we get ready for our offering this morning, let your offering be a sign of your worship. Amen. I want for all of us, as we give up our tithes and our offering, as we come up here in front, I want for us to give this as an offering to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus at the center of it all.
Come on. You can now give your offerings to the
Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you. Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been.
Center of my
Extend our hands towards the offerings this morning. Father, we just bless you and thank you. Yes, Lord God. It's all about you. It's all about what you're doing in our lives. You are the only one that matters most to us. And Father, as we lift up to you our offerings this morning, let this be a sweet-smelling essence unto your nostrils. This is an offering, Lord, coming from our hearts. And Lord, we just thank you, Father God, that these are our offerings coming from your children that has acknowledged that you are the source of all. So we bless you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.